I thought things would be different. But it's like he's still here, watching me. Every day is just as miserable, just as loveless. There is no point to my life. I can't go on.
Come and see how you're doing. See his home then?
Yes.
How are you coping?
I'm fine. I just need to keep myself busy.
Mm. Yeah. Should we make a start in the garden then?
I've been meaning to put those away somewhere.
Well, you know, I understand it's hard to let go. I mean, Mum always said you and him was inseparable.
No, that's not true. I'll get us some gloves for the garden.
Auntie Rose? What's wrong?
I can't pretend anymore, Mandy. It was all a lie.
I realise.
He was cruel and vindictive.
Well, to be honest, I never really liked him very much. But I never thought for
one... It started not long after we were married and ended when he died. I got very good at hiding the bruises.
Why did you stay with him, Auntie Rose?
I was scared. The worst is, it's like he's still here. Controlling me.
Maybe you should get rid of his stuff.
What?
Well, it can't help having everything lying around. And...
No.
Well, I just think it'd help if you...
I said no. There's some junk in the attic needs burning. Those can go on the fire.
Auntie Rose...
And after that, I'll pop the kettle on. I don't know about you, but I'm parched.
Auntie Rose, please. After everything you've been through with Uncle Frank, don't you think you should think about getting some counselling?
Mandy, I'll deal with this in my own way.
But what if you don't?
Then I promise I'll see someone, all right?
Okay.
Auntie Rose, what are these?
Did Uncle Frank write these? I'm scared Uncle Frank would find him.
No! With his bad leg, he could never get up to the attic.
So he never suspected.
But it wasn't like that. I met Elisha years before. He used to come and hear me sing.
Sing?
In a folk band. That's another thing your Uncle Frank stopped when we got married.
Never knew that.
We were very much in love. And we're going to get married.
Well, why didn't you?
He was from a very strict Jewish family. And they looked down on me. And they arranged for him to marry someone else.
Oh, that's such a shame.
He refused. And then his mum... fell ill. And he relented.
You never saw him again? You never tried contacting him?
No.
Well, maybe you should.
You're not serious.
Yeah, I mean, just as friends, you know. See what became of him.
Well, I couldn't. No!
You know, he can't hurt you now.
Mandy, you don't understand. He would never let me even look at another man, never mind talk to one.
Yeah, but you're free of him now. You can do whatever you want.
No, I can't. It's too soon.
Auntie Rose, he's gone.
I know. I'm not deluded.
Bye, Auntie
Rose.
Thank
you, darling.
My darling Rose, no matter how hard I try, I just can't forget you. All day long, I've played our song over and over again.
My young love said to me, my brothers won't mind, and my father won't slight you for your lack of kind. Then she turned.
Whatever happens, I will love you forever. And I know fate will bring us together again.
It will not be long, love, till our wedding day.
You never did believe in fate. And you never loved me.
Come in. Oh, Auntie Rose.
The receptionist told me to come through.
Yeah, come in, come in. Is everything all right?
I've decided to take your advice. I would like to try and find Elijah.
What's changed your mind?
Well, it's like you said. There's nothing stopping me.
So, have you tried the phone book?
Yes. But nothing. I wondered if you could help.
If I can.
Well, he was training to be a doctor, and I wondered if there was some sort of medical database you could access.
We'll have a look.
Click on the photograph. That's him!
Are you sure?
Apart from the white hair, he's hardly changed at all. Just as handsome as ever.
Looks like his practice isn't too far away.
Would you mind driving me?
No. No, I can finish this later.
Great. Could you print out the photo?
Auntie Rose, now, I know this was my idea.
I know what you're going to say, but I don't expect him to still have feelings for me.
Good. Because he's probably got his own family.
I know. But I just want to say hello and see what happened to him. That's all.
Okay.
Ready. What's wrong?
Nothing. It just Looks like you've gone to a lot of effort.
Hardly. I just felt like wearing a dress. Shall we go?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Well, let's not jump to conclusions, eh?
But it's a one-doctor surgery. It says so on the website.
Rose, let's just see first. You go and wait in the car and I'll see if there's anyone to ask.
What did they say?
They said Dr. Kaskel died recently.
No.
Oh, Rose, I'm so sorry. I'm unveiling the headstone at the village cemetery.
I need to go.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
I must say goodbye.
Auntie Rose.
No. I can't.
Oh, come on, let's sit down over here. Come on. Are you okay? Come on, I'll drive you home.
No. I want to stay a while. You go. I'll be fine.
Okay. I'll ring you later.
There is no point to my life. I can't go on. Last night she came to me. My dead love came in.
So softly she entered that her feet made no din. Hello, Rose.
How did you know?
I saw the date of birth on the gravestone and guessed it was his father's.
I took over his practice when he fell ill. I know it's been a long time. A lifetime, in fact. But I'm so happy to see you.
Me too.
Dream that my dead love come in. So softly she entered that her feet made no din.